Hello everyone, this is Kelly Beard of KarmicTools.com and this is your weekly forecast for April 12th through the 18th of 2020. And our week kicks off on Tuesday the 14th with Sun squaring Pluto. So you know, since Jupiter and Pluto are so close together, the very next day on the 15th, Sun's going to square Jupiter. So first we transform, then we change the story. Interesting dynamic. When Sun squares Pluto, that also makes it individual. It makes it personal. We can work with it more directly, let's just say. And I encourage you to do that right now because it's easier than ever to just utterly change your life. This is a challenge to grow out of your comfort zone and into new territory. That said, with Pluto in Capricorn 2008 to 2024, twice a year for 16 years when the Sun is in Aries in the spring or Libra in the fall, we get this opportunity to grow and change in fundamental departments of life, which means self versus other and home versus work. In this case, and during these years, we are literally changing how we do all of the basics. Each year builds on the previous, and we are now 12 years into the 16-year process of transformation. That is three-quarters of the way and an incredibly dynamic point in time and space. It is here that you have the most information to consciously work with as you prepare for the next 4 years, and ultimately what you would like to get out of your conscious efforts and dedication. Sun helps us clarify, and when working with Pluto, it is usually what is not working, what has run its course, and is ready to be composted into new life, new growth, and a new direction for self. Deep breath. Pluto is the purifier, distilling things back to their true and original essence. Fight that, and it can be painful. Work with it consciously, and it can be transformative and will heal at the deepest root of any challenge. You can use this activation to honor that which has become obvious or is highlighted in the here and now and purge or purify this energy. You are deeply supported for releasing old patterns and setting new conscious practices into action. Tie up loose ends, close multiple chapters, mourn if you must, and move on. As you do that, you will feel lighter and brighter and more grounded in your true self, your evolved self. Deep breath. We are all evolving. And the 14th is Tuesday, so that's my Instagram live day. I hope you can join me. It stays on Instagram for 24 hours, and after that, I load it up to my Karmic Tools YouTube channel for the replays. So here in the blog, last week's replay is here, and it was Recalibrated Relationships with the Libra Super Full Moon. It was a lot of fun, and this time we kept it under an hour for those of you who don't like the long marathons we get into. So like I said, that first activation with Sun square Pluto is transforming you, the individual, so that this next one with Jupiter, you can change your story in some fundamental way because you have been changed in a fundamental way. This is a powerful energy, and with that comes the necessity of discernment. It provokes you to get a lot of things accomplished, and that's a good thing. However, beware of taking on more than you can actually handle. Having said that, now, if you need a little push to get some things done, this is just the energy for you. It carries with it the optimism necessary to allow you to go beyond your norm and stretch in new ways. Sometimes there can be a tendency towards self-righteousness with this energy, but try to make it self-directed and you will benefit greatly. Walk your talk, embody your truth. However, if you turn it on others, demanding that they believe what you believe, you may have some difficulties. Be open and receptive. Have a don't-know mind, like a beginner's mind, because you never know what you may learn along the way that could really help you now or in the future. So this is the thing where I would actually recommend you engage my Sag prayer. This is the prayer. Thank you for revealing my blind spot in time to cultivate a positive, effective response. And then follow it up with, and thank you for revealing my hidden potential in time to cultivate a positive, effective response. That's what Sun square Jupiter is best for. It's going to probably point out some things about yourself and magnify them. That's what Jupiter does. So for better or worse, we're expanding in some way. Or we want to expand and we're feeling very limited, so we have to work something out to get there. But this is the other side of, like I said, that transformation that goes on with Pluto first leads to being able to tell a new story, because not only do you believe something new, but you've now had a new experience that has changed you. And how is that going to work into your personal story? And so that's the 15th, which is Wednesday. Thursday, the 16th, is my first of two. I'm having a two-part introduction to the new Venus cycle. So if you haven't seen the article already, it is in here linked in the blog as well. It is in every form possible, so if you need to read it, listen to it, or watch a video, it's all in different forms, and the links are in the blog. I hope you will join us on Thursday, April 16th, as we introduce the new Venus cycle in Gemini. We are already in the zone of influence and exploring territory where she will extend her stay, so we're getting some clues right now. I am hosting two free calls. This first one will cover the cycle in general and some of the larger implications to the social and collective realms. This way, we can also unify a vision of how we'd like to see this cycle unfold together. That night, I will go over what this cycle is truly best for so we can set our intentions as a community. I'm excited to share it with you and look forward to going even deeper with those of you who have Gemini, Sag, Virgo, Pisces activated in your chart, because on the second free introductory call the next week, Thursday the 23rd of April, I will go over what the individuals who are being most directly affected will have for energetic support and guidance. As for the rest of us, we should look to the houses that are ruled by those signs and see which areas of life are being stirred up by Venus's extended stay in Gemini or your Gemini-ruled house. So here you can also register to receive the replay and custom goodies. And that is Thursday. And then we jump to Saturday, the 18th, brings two Mercury activations. And this is wild because Venus is in Gemini, Mars is in Aquarius. Mercury is fresh into Aries. So this air and fire is creating some inspiration and some guidance and some direction around your masculine-feminine dynamics. But that, in translated in human form, is how we get anything done. The feminine contains, nurtures, protects. The masculine is the part of you that negotiates on your behalf, gets your ideas in the world, and holds good boundaries. So Mercury's just out of retrograde zone and finally into Aries and into new territories with the new ideas or the new beginning or the new first step that you need to consider. So in a sextile is a positive activation, and it's good for gaining traction in a way that we haven't been able to possibly wrap our brains around until now, let's say. So Saturday, Mercury sextiling Venus first. This is a great opportunity to beautify your ideas, improve or deepen them so they are expressing more of your unique authenticity. Yes, get creative wherever you are. Communication in relationships usually goes well under this influence too. This energy can turn your thoughts and ideas toward how you feel and what inspires you with love and beauty. This is a great time to be particularly creative or do something that activates your own inner artist. It is best to keep it light and let go of your mundane burdens just for a time. Pleasure reading, now a walk on the beach, a play or museum are all good things to do at some point this week if possible. So I've heard that museums are doing tours online and there's lots of things to do another way. But when you can't physically do it, that's when you start looking for books or magazines or, you know, images for your imagination to play with. Same day, Mercury is going to sextile Mars. So this is a healthy, selfish energy, I say, also known as self-preservation. Do not hold back this week. If you have a big dream or a serious goal you have been working toward, then this is the time that may attract the assistance you need from the universe. This is definitely a work energy, though. So it brings with it the caveat that it is also best to work alone on something important to you. No one else is or ever will be as dedicated to your goal as you will be, nor should you expect them to be. You are now connected to that extra energy it takes to push your goals to the next level, bringing you a sense of accomplishment while also outlining the next tasks to be done. Opportunities present themselves all the time. All you have to do is be ready. If you are given an opportunity to make a presentation, go for it. Your clarity, energy, and enthusiasm will be unmatched, and that's what people respond to. Don't choose this time to shy away or doubt that you're ready. You are definitely ready, otherwise you wouldn't be here. One of my favorite sayings is, at the moment of commitment, the universe conspires to assist you. It's time to decide if you are committed and how truly committed you are to your own success. Okay, so here's the deal. I probably said this along the way during the Mercury retrograde, that by this time we would be able to take action. Obviously, actions are limited. But what I will encourage that is also supportive of this energy is just to explore your choices and think outside the box. Really stretch your imagination. If nothing's in place, then anything's possible. I've been saying that for years because things have not been in place for years. So getting used to that and learning to improvise and think on your feet and create different stories. It's time to tell a new story. We are writing the new story. So over the weekend, this Saturday the 18th, when Mercury's stirring it up with your Venus and Mars, it's time to blend those parts of yourself, your right and left hemispheres of the brain, your creative self and your practical self, and bring that together with some new creative solutions on how to go forward on the other side of this. At the moment, we're talking about the weekly forecast, the 12th to the 18th of April. And at this moment, I keep hearing that May 1st is when non-essential businesses can go back to real life. That could change in the next 2 weeks before May 1st. So let's, again, be flexible. Be exploring the possibilities without attachment or commitment to any of them just yet. But try to plan on this evolving incrementally. I don't think it's going to get resolved in a day for anybody. So it's going to be increments of freedom that are restored to us little by little by little. So let's call in the new vision of what that looks like. How can we travel with more ease and grace? How is this bigger shift creating opportunities that we would have never considered if our backs weren't up against the wall, basically? So get creative and have a good week. Stay strong, stay positive. Check in and catch up with all the videos and audios and things that maybe you don't always have time for from Kelly. I hope you can join me for the Venus Circle introduction, or if you want the replay, all you got to do is register, and that will go out to anyone that registered. That's it for this week. Thank you so much for being part of my community and sharing this time and journey with me. I'm right there with you, and we're all evolving. Trust that you can reach out, and I'm here if you need me. Take care.
Thanks for listening. This is Kelly Beard of KarmicTools.com, and I am so grateful for your time, energy, and support. Please share this with those you think would resonate and reach out if and when you need to, Kelly@KarmicTools.com. The goal of my weekly forecast is to alert you to the energies and activations that we're all experiencing and the possibilities for conscious co-creation as an individual. Awareness of the energies is the first key, but I invite you to take it to the next level by checking out my readings, telecircles, and subscriptions, which are all geared toward individual support that helps you understand your own unique blueprint. My specialty is cycles and patterns, and I love helping people figure out their own within the context of the social and collective rhythm. To some, working with their own cycles and patterns is a completely new and foreign concept, but there are many planetary cycles that coincide with natural life cycles that allow us to co-create in mystical as well as practical ways. I create custom tools that I have tried and tested myself for over 30 years, and I do the work alongside my circle every time. So I hope you will reach out if you feel called to dive deeper into your own soul's natural rhythm. Talk to you soon. One love.